Good afternoon. For all Western New York news, I'm Scott Lemel. Mostly sunny today in Western New York. The daytime high in Buffalo and Rochester will be about 49 degrees, while it'll dip to about 40 overnight in Buffalo, 37 in Rochester. What's in the news? Most municipalities have trick-or-treating today. Times are different in different places. We have a pretty comprehensive list available for you at allwesternnewyorknews.com. Speaking of trick-or-treating, make sure kids are safe when they go out tonight. Erie County Sheriff Tim Howard and AAA each offer safety tips, which we've also posted to All Western New York News. Some basics: parents, go with your kids, go before dark, have kids wear reflective tape if they're out after dark, don't let your kids go into strangers' homes, and check candy before they eat it. Drivers, be careful. There's a bunch of kids walking around out there. Starting tomorrow, the state's move over law now applies to garbage trucks too. If you can't move over, you have to slow down. If you do neither, it could cost you $400. Attorney General Eric Schneiderman issued an updated brochure on Sunday offering tips to New Yorkers buying health insurance coverage for 2017. The pamphlet, titled Shopping for Health Insurance Coverage, is being released in advance of the New York State of Health Marketplace's open enrollment period starting on Tuesday. Have you seen this Buffalo Hyperlapse video yet? If not, you have to watch it. Luke Hagg tells us he spent about 3.5 months on the 3.5 minute video. There's 4,500 individual still shots in the video. Go watch now. We shared the Vimeo video and some of Luke's thoughts. Police news. A 26-year-old Lockport woman was charged Friday with endangering the welfare of a child accused of purchasing marijuana for a 15-year-old. Police say the teen gave Angel M. Sani approximately $20 to purchase marijuana for both individuals to smoke. Sani was located, placed under arrest, and transported to the Lockport Troopers Barracks for processing. She was issued an appearance ticket, returnable to Town of Lockport Court at a later date. New York State Troopers charged 2 people with driving while intoxicated and 4 more with drug-related offenses during a fixed sobriety checkpoint on Saturday. Charged with DWI were 29-year-old Kelly Igo of Depew and 49-year-old Darren Hebe of West Seneca, while 21-year-old Anthony Peters of Orchard Park was charged with possession of concentrated cannabis. All 3 will appear in the Town of Elma Court at a later date to answer to the charges. Troopers arrested 3 other persons for unlawful possession of marijuana, and 1 additional person was arrested for felony DWI by the Town of West Seneca Police Department. Over 600 people passed through the checkpoint. Sports. The Tom Brady-led Patriots dismantled the Buffalo Bills Sunday afternoon, scoring 41 points while holding Buffalo to just 25, and 8 of those were scored after the game was essentially over. You can read the recap at allwesternnewyorksports.com, but I'd suggest just pretending it didn't happen. The Buffalo Sabres, on the other hand, found the net again, beating the Winnipeg Jets 3-1 Sunday afternoon. They next play on Tuesday in Minnesota. In college sports, UB's men's soccer won 1-0 over Oral Roberts. UB's women's soccer, however, ended their season with a loss to number 3 Central Michigan, 1-0. The Niagara University volleyball team fell in straight sets to Siena. Canisius volleyball lost to Marist 3-1 despite outblocking them 15.5-5. Niagara and Canisius will face off on Wednesday. Stephanie Ward and Jordan Johnson were named the Athletes of the Week by the University at Buffalo. It's the 2nd time this season for each student. Johnson was also named the Mid-American Conference East Division Offensive Player of the Week. It's Monday, so that means Greg Burt's weekly column, Heard in Western New York, was published this morning. His top show of the week is Jimmy and Ballsy's wedding reception Saturday night. Also, tonight, For the Music Productions, Graveyard Bash, is at Evening Star Concert Hall in Niagara Falls. Doors open at 6. Of course, there's a slew of other events posted at allwesternnewyorkevents.com. That's the news for the day. Bringing it to you, for All Western New York News, I'm Scott Leffler.